every kid, right, they got a sport, span, and Joe wanted to be a soccer player. And being I'm from Sardinia, you know, it's all us place, right? I'd brought up in Sardinia. But obviously, I brought up in Bedford as well, actually in Bedford. And football was my dream, always dreamt football. So in any case, Joe wanted to be a soccer player. But one particular day, they didn't pick him in school, right? For some reason or another, we don't know, probably biases, right? After Joe started, came back home crying, "Dad, you never picked me, never picked me." So I thought myself, okay. I had a cushion, big cupboard where it is in the house. So I bought him a punch bag, like this floor ceiling one. Joe said, "Start punching it, learn a bit of punching." And he really enjoyed it. A funny thing about it, that there was we were in a new estate camp, another site, and down about half a mile, there was actually a gym. That's a fluke. Absolutely, just built out of the estate. And there was down the road, there was a boxing club. So obviously I took him to a boxing club, and he loved it. He loved it. I thought, bloody hell, brilliant. So from there onwards, obviously, you grew up to 8, 9, 10, and started enjoying the boxing there, right? And the story becomes then, he started winning ABA champions, ABA titles, ABA titles. Everyone is saying already, this guy is going to be a superstar. He only needs common sense about it. But obviously, I was linking with him, as obviously I'm his father, but I like the training method, and learning more, it's my training method. And today, as you can go on and talk, and that's why and why. But he created this guy, which is a special type of boxer. They're not boasting, the world knows about it, right? And I myself never trained him myself. I was not a trainer. As I come nowhere, I didn't know nothing about boxing. I was a soccer player, a musician, actually, I was a musician. For some reason, it gelled together because obviously what I visualized is a style of different boxing, which obviously me and Joe happened to be gelled well in, and everybody enjoyed that style. But in any case, for us, it's very successful. And to this very day, that style remains unique. And obviously, we created and defeated Joe Calzaghe. Simple as that. The proudest moment is genius courage. It's very courageous, right? Listen, it wasn't a rose and glory. Let's make sure, right? He had 46 world title, not world title, but 40 unbeaten TV, but he had 26 world title fights. They're going to be bleeping one there. Like when he was just told they had world title fights, 26 world title fights in a row, some way, I was never, ever scared. Never scared. That every title, we know, when Joe wins, when someone wins the world title, everybody's after your ass. They're after you to get the title off you, correct? And what he did, basically, is he was confident. The word confident. And I was so confident about my ability to train him. That's where it gelled in well. But Joe knew his father wasn't his father on a fight night. I was divorced. I was a trainer, not a father. And I had that guts to say, I'm a trainer, not a father. I didn't have no intention to cry over him when he dropped. No way. I said, get up. Another trainer would say, another father would say, that's my father. That's my son. That's my son. No way. So that's the power that Joe wanted. He went to a trainer, that responds to his ability, which I did. And I think that's the reason now, honestly, Joe, we embrace each other as a family now, but that particular bearer is completely different. We had the heart of the family, has always been there. And today, this is what we got. I think it's a great film, fantastic film. Norman done a fantastic job. I've seen films in my life, boxing films, but this is special. Absolutely. Not because of me, okay, and Joe, with the personality in it, but obviously, Vaughan made a special kind of documentary, which I think everyone around the world will see because of what he done. I give him 10 out of 10 for that.